Hi guys, my name is Kiva and welcome back to DIY with KB. So the new Studio McGee collection drops and I know we're all super excited about it. Now last time I don't think went as according to plan as they had hoped. People really struggled to get the items, a lot of things arrived broken, or the quality just wasn't up to par. But I have purchased some of the items already and I think that the quality is there this time. I didn't review the last collection because the style just wasn't me. I have a really modern home and I'm gonna keep it that way, and I felt like their products were super niche. But this time I really think they've diversified. So in today's video, we're not just talking about the collection, I'm talking to you about the Studio McGee items that will work in a modern, industrial, Scandinavian, glam home. All of the different styles, I'm gonna let you know what products you can actually integrate and which ones you should just leave at the store. So if you're excited for that, be sure to keep on watching. I'm saving the very best for last, and know that my virtual design sessions are back. So if you want me to design your home, click the link down in my description box. We would have so much fun together. And remember to subscribe, like this video, and check me out on Instagram at kiva.brent. Now let's get into it. The first item I want to start with is this terracotta crossbase bowl by Studio McGee. I actually picked it up far before I knew that it was Studio McGee, and I love this bowl. It is reasonably priced. It's around $30 or $35, I'm not quite sure. But I love it because it has that nice earthy feel, which we always want to add a touch of that in a modern home because we want to stop things from feeling too sterile. Because that's something that can happen a lot when you're doing a lot of black and white and grays and really a monochrome color palette. What I would do with this vase is you could fill it with moss or something like that. Online you can see here that she actually fills it up with fruit, so that's something else you could do. I think what you fill it with kind of dictates the direction that you can take this bowl in, and I think that's a really important point. It's all, vessels are vessels. You have to decide what they are a vessel for and therefore choose something that is going to work with your design style. Now, I love this for the price, and I wanted to show you something that was kind of comparable. So again, this is the one from Studio McGee, and then this is a similar type of bowl from Restoration Hardware. Now this was $71 and this one was $35, and you can see that they're made out of things that are pretty similar in my opinion. They have a lot of texture in them, and I will say that this one is a lot heavier than the Restoration Hardware one. It's very sturdy. I don't feel like it's gonna break. So this is very well made, and so I think we need to give them props on this one, and I would definitely recommend that you pick it up. The next item is the Pleasant Grove marble coffee table, and I really love this piece because who doesn't love a good marble coffee table? They didn't choose to do a marble top with, like, you know, a wooden frame. They did a marble top with a black frame, so that's really accessible for almost every design style. And they have two of them. They have a round one and a rectangular one, so there is some variety there. This is a perfect thing for a black and white home, a glam home, a Scandinavian home. I think you could fit this in just about anywhere, and it's very reasonably priced. I think they did a phenomenal job with this piece. And I love, again, that this is a round coffee table, because round coffee tables of quality are so very hard to find, and round coffee tables add a new shape to spaces that are normally full of rectangles. I continue to say that, but it's really important to have some differences in what you have going on in the room, because a room is meant to be interesting to look at, and I think you can achieve that with this coffee table. Now, the Rustic rug, it is a jute rug. I'm thinking about buying it, you guys, and jute isn't even my style. So let me tell you why I think this is a great piece. This is jute and black mixed together, and I think jute and black provide a really nice contrast. When you think jute, you always think farmhouse, but when you add that touch of black, it becomes a lot more earthy. You just have like that twine feel. You can see this all the time in houses such as the designer Athena Calderon. You see this all the time when you search earthy modern on Pinterest. Jute rugs are really making a comeback, or just not even a comeback, they're really appearing in modern homes. So this one is really great because it has the juxtaposition again between the traditional and the modern, and we like to add texture, and I personally don't like throw pillows, so I need to find a place to add texture somewhere other than pillows. So the rug provides a really good opportunity to do so, and I think the price is really phenomenal. I think Target rugs actually are priced really well to begin with compared to other stores, and you can pick them up in person and you can return them really easily, which I think is super, super important. And it comes in a massive size. 7x10 is not a trivial size. That's gonna work in most people's homes. So I'm really pleased with this option. This slip-covered sofa is giving me such Leanne Ford Crate and Barrel vibes. It also reminds me of Pottery Barn, but this sofa is only $900. A slip-covered sofa like this would cost you at least, I want to say, $20.99. That's the number coming off of my head. Let's just call this the prices, right? But I love this sofa. I also love that it is a dark gray. I love having ivory furniture. I love white sofas, but there is a lot of upkeep if you like breathe near your furniture, right? Because they're so easy to stain. So this one is a really good color. It is a nice deep gray. It would look amazing in a media room, a man cave, a living room, a office. I literally just listed every room in the house because it would look good in every single room of the house. I love the colors, and the slip covered look adds a little soft touch, you know, because it does have the track arms, but the slip covered look, you're like, oh, it's giving me beachy vibes. It keeps it a little bit light and airy, whereas, you know, if it had just like the track arms with a really solid base, it would look a little bit too modern for a lot of people. So I love this piece of furniture because it can work again in different styles, and the price is phenomenal. Sofas are really expensive. This one isn't. I'm actually pretty curious as to assembly and how they ship it. If you do buy it, let me know down in the comments if it was easy to assemble, because that's something that I like to factor into furniture when I buy it and when I recommend it. Because if you have to put it together yourself, you have to think about whether it warranted that price. I think about that with IKEA all the time. Sometimes I buy things and I'm like, ugh, that wasn't it. But this might be a case where it is totally worth it. So please keep me updated and let me know down below. I am completely obsessed with this Lark metal chair. Oh my God, it would work in every style. I've actually been looking for accent chairs and I have my eye on that one. It has a nice metal frame. So again, metal, we wanna add metal in spaces because it adds, again, a new texture, a new type of something. You need diversity in the things that you own, and metal provides that. It adds a little bit of shininess in an otherwise matte home. You kind of get my point. Actually looks a lot like a lot of restoration hardware accent chairs that go for at least, I want to say, at least $1,200. This one is super affordable. As you can see from the picture here, it works in the homes that Studio McGee designs, but it also could work in a modern home, again, a Scandinavian. I'm not gonna keep listing them because I think you can get my point. Overall, this collection has proven to be a lot more diverse than the previous one, and I think that's going to be great for a lot of us. Something else I wanna say, maybe this is my bonus tip of the day, that you might be looking at some of these prices and saying, wow, that's way too expensive. Sure, it's more expensive than what you normally pay at Target, but if you're looking at other luxury stores where the quality probably is comparable, we'll have to wait and see, but where the quality is probably comparable, they are basically giving away this stuff. So I just want you to consider that while you are making purchases. You have to think about money relative to like other items. If she's selling you a sofa, you're not gonna get a sofa for $200 or not any sofa of quality. So again, just consider that. This Vernon upholstered barrel chair is to die for. It is beautiful. I don't really love the brown color, only because it won't work in my home, but brown is a really good accent. What's really actually becoming a trend this year is black, white, and brown, and then an earth tone, so like a light wood. So think about that, but this chair is only $270, and a barrel chair, even at Wayfair, is at least $400. So this, again, is a steal at Restoration Hardware. It'd be a lot more money. The barrel chairs that, not, they're not technically barrel chairs, but the Leanne Ford chairs that look kind of like barrel chairs, I think they're like $899 at least. So again, this price is a steal. I like that it looks like it's velvet. I'm not quite sure of the texture, but it's really interesting to look at. The light hits it differently from different angles, and it looks really comfortable. I think it's really important to incorporate one piece of furniture at least that is kind of cozy, especially in a home like mine. I love it to just look staged all the time, but sometimes you just want to sit back somewhere that's really cozy and make it feel like you live there. And I think you could achieve that with this chair. And again, you could take this in any different stylistic direction. You could keep it completely bare and not add anything to it. If you're doing a modern home, you could add some type of nice velvet accent pillow if you're in a glam home. Again, you can take these things in different directions. There are fewer patterns in this new collection, which means you can use these things in any way that you want. I love these emery wood dining chairs. I love them. If I didn't already have chairs, I'd think about buying them. Again, not really my style, but I love them. They're only $90. I actually am obsessed with the counter stool version, but they're out of stock as of right now, and I don't want to link you to anything that you can't actually get, because that really irritates me when people do that to me. I love the little pillow feel. I don't know, they're just so comfy and cozy. It looks just like that bigger chair and the ottoman that everyone had from last collection. You have them in the chairs now, and I really love that. Because these chairs are so affordable, let me tell you what I'm gonna do. So when the counter stools come back in stock, I'm gonna buy them because they're only $120. I can't find a counter stool of quality for, you know, less than $120 absolutely anywhere. So I'm gonna buy this counter stool, and then I'm going to spray paint the frame matte black. And it's gonna be like a bam. It's gonna look like the Anders chairs a little bit from Restoration Hardware, which are a pretty penny, and I'm gonna get the same look for virtually no money because I already have a spray paint. So altogether, what, it's gonna cost me $123 perhaps, and it's gonna look so good. Again, when the prices are low, then you can upcycle the things a little bit. You can DIY them. Don't, if you're spending $800 on something, it better be the best thing you've ever seen ever. But if something is really cheap, you can take it to the next level on your own. So I really like these dining chairs and counter stools really provide the opportunity to do that. And when I do it, I'll definitely show it to you. This Bell Canyon solid wood dining table is a steal. It's $500. It comes in an espresso and a natural color. So I wouldn't put this in my home because those are my colors, but it's only $500 and it sits up to 6 people. It's 72 inches and that's amazing. That's an amazing price. Again, it looks like some of the Crate and Barrel tables that are at least, I wanna say $12.99, and you're getting the exact same look. Again, if you had a farmhouse and you're trying to make it a little bit warmer, a little bit less farmhouse and a little bit more traditional, you're gonna add brown colors like this with these really clean lines to kind of modernize it a little bit but not completely overhaul your style. Again, it's little things that you add to really shift your style. You don't have to throw everything out one day like me. It's a bad practice. Don't be like me. But I love this table. It sits six people, which is a good number of people. This table is really good. I love that they have these bigger items. If you're shopping with Studio McGee, make sure to also look online because they're not gonna have the, you know, 72 inch table sitting in the middle of Target. There's just not space for that. So make sure you're looking online as well. I will have this link down below. And I'm gonna carry this into the next item because not only do they have the rectangular version of this table, but they also have a round version of this table. Round dining tables are so in this year, and I love that for us. I love that for us, but they are so expensive. They're so expensive. A round table that's normally 48 inches and sits, you know, 2 to 4 people is normally at least $1,000. That's a lot of money for a table that can literally sit me, babe, and the dog. I really like that this one is a lot more affordable. It comes in the same colors, and you can put really funky chairs with this and kind of make it cozy. I love round dining tables because I feel like they're more conducive to conversation because everyone can really see each other well. Whereas when you're sitting at a rectangular dining table, you're like, hey, Bob. Hopefully you heard me, maybe you didn't. So this is a phenomenal option, and you can pair it with her chairs or other chairs at Target. Target has phenomenal dining chairs, so be on the lookout for that as well. Again, if you're buying her items, you're shopping in store, also look at the other items in Target, style in store, and you're gonna get yourself a beautiful home on a budget. Next, we have the Layton faux leather accent chair, and guys, oh my God, I'm telling you, I'm doing a man cave soon, and this is the first thing I am proposing to him. I love this chair. I love the brown versus the wood color. It is so manly, and I like that. I like that. It would look good in an industrial home, in a Scandinavian home. Leather is in right now, but sometimes we don't want real leather. We want the faux leather, easier to take care of. No animals were hurt, and we love that for us. So really good option. I really like how Studio McGee adds these browns to these really light color palettes to be like, okay, let's not talk about gender here, but feminine and masculine design, it exists. I can't do anything about it. So you can have a really feminine room and then you add this little pop of brown to make it a little bit more masculine to balance it out, because a home cannot just represent one person who lives there. They actually have a matching little magazine holder or book holder, and they also have ottomans that match this as well. So it's a really, really great set. A chair like this is so interesting to look at that this could be one of the situations where you have a sofa and just one accent chair. Most of the time I recommend two because I like to really define a living room, but this one speaks so much for itself. It could stand on its own, which I think is really phenomenal. The Thousand Oaks two-door scallop cabinet is $300, and I love the vibes. I've tried to DIY something like this for years, and when I say try it, I mean I just thought about it. But I really love it, and it's only $300, so there's no reason to DIY it, just buy it. It comes in the natural wood grain. This could be really great at an entryway, a sideboard in a dining room. It could look anywhere, look good anywhere. And again, it's the right tone of wood where you could add it as a pop to really any design style and it not really like throw off your design, which I really love. The This is something also, it's so affordable. You could spray paint it. I do want to say that when you're buying items like this, you need to look at the finish on items because you can ruin them really quickly if you don't know what you're doing. But I think it looks really good on its own. And look to Studio McGee for inspiration on how to style this. I really love that about the collection online. They style absolutely everything. Whereas with other lines at Target, they're kind of like, this is the base versus this other vase that we're selling, and that's it, the end. I don't know what you're gonna do with it. So I love that they took the time to do that with this collection. It's really cute. That's really all I have to say about it. In a modern home, again, yes, I would do it on a credenza. I'd probably put like a taupe black, light brown painting above it, and I'd put some black vessels and like maybe a vessel like the earthy ones that I showed you from RH earlier. And I think it'd be a really nice, again, juxtaposition of colors. That word is stuck in my head for the day, but I'm here for it. The next rug I want to talk about is the Marina hand woven wool rug in cream. In 7x10, it is only $200. When have you ever gotten a wool rug for $200? That is an amazing price for what it is made out of. I'm sure it's not like the best wool on the planet, but still, really good find. You're not going to get that sheeny undertone that you get with like the rayon rugs. So I'm really happy about that. This again adds a really nice light touch to a room. If you have dark furniture, you can put this underneath and not prevent the room from feeling small, which happens when you have dark furniture. This also would look phenomenal in a beach home. That's kind of where I see it, and I really like that. It also gives me serious Serena and Lily vibes. If you don't know Serena and Lily, they are like on the come up. They're amazing. Their prices are kind of high, so this is a really good option if you're trying to get that look for less. So again, Studio McGee was super successful with this choice. I think you could put this in just about any house. Oh, and a country house, it would be wonderful. I know we're all stuck in our homes right now. So I think this would be a really good way to change things up. The Murray round ceramic side table is giving me 100% CB2 vibes. It is round, which is a different shape. It is stone, so a new texture, and it is speckled. So while it is pure white, it does have another color in it, so it's a little bit more interesting. What I love about this is that it is a pure white. So again, if you have a darker room, it's going to brighten it up, but it's a small piece. You don't have to overhaul all of your furniture. Again, I really love this because you could also probably buy it in store instead of having it shipped to you, so you can actually see it in person. Think about the height of your sofa or your accent chair before you buy it, because you don't want to get a side table that is too small. I think people also really struggle with styling round side tables. So again, look to the Target website and how Studio McGee did it, because again, they do a great job of exemplifying how to use their products. I would say that this actually looks more modern, Scandinavian, industrial, more than what it was actually intended for. So I think that that's great for the modern home decor lovers like us. This is my absolute favorite item from the collection. I am so excited. If I needed them, I would buy them. I'm talking about the upholstered chairs. And you're saying, Kiva, you already have upholstered chairs. Yes, I do. And they look identical, but my chairs are out of stock and these chairs are in stock. They are cream or ivory dining chairs. They're big and bulky, and it's a nice pillow to sit on while you're eating dinner. And you cannot go wrong with these. You're gonna have to order them. They go out of stock all the time. They were in the last collection, but I had to include them here. But sign up for those email alerts because they are incredible. I'm telling you, I love my chairs so much that not only do we eat dinner here, but I also sit here and do work all the time, even though I have an office, because they're just so comfortable. They give me good back support, and I'm sure that these Studio McGee chairs are exactly the same. I want to let you know that you may be inclined with a chair like this to try and use it as an accent chair, and you need to think about the height first, because you can't have like a low chair like this, which is meant for a dining table, in your living room. It's gonna make it look stumpy. You don't want that, but otherwise, really good option. And last, but certainly not least, we have the weathered jug vase in brown. This is a small one. It is only $20, and it's so cute. It is a nice pop of earthiness. Now, I will say, as you can see here, there are a lot of sticker marks in it, which, you know, that happens. I mean, I also want to say that we attack Studio McGee, but she's also not the manufacturer, but I digress. We can talk about that on Instagram or in the comments. Let me know your thoughts on the last collab down below, but it was only $20. I think it's really well made, and again, these items are a lot sturdier than the last collection. I can feel that by how I'm touching them. This is heavy, and I really like that. It is brown, but honestly, it has reddish hues in my opinion. Again, really nice pop of earthiness. I would probably get the small and the large version and a bunch of other little small vessels somewhere from like Crate and Barrel and put it in a curio cabinet. And I think that that will look super cute. But for the price, you're not gonna beat it. One like this that is made out of plastic from at home actually costs more than this. At Restoration Hardware, this is gonna cost you a ton of money. The only comparable place I'd probably say is Crate and Barrel, but I love these, 10 out of 10. I would definitely buy them. Okay guys, that's it for today's video. I'm telling you, the new Studio McGee collection has a ton of things I think you're gonna love. I have, again, this bowl and this vase, and they're so well made. I didn't know they were Studio McGee because I picked them up. I live in Pittsburgh and everything comes out early here, and I love that for me. Everything is really well made. I think you're gonna love it, and a lot of their items work regardless of your design style. So even if you are traditional or transitional like Studio McGee, there's something for you. So you're gonna get that designer look for less, and I'm so excited for you. Let me know down in the comments what items you picked up last collab drop, and tell me what you're getting this drop. I really wanna know. I'm putting in a huge order the second I turn off the camera. Thank you so much for watching today's video. Remember, design sessions are back, so if you wanna work with me, click the link down in my description box. Until next time, have a beautiful day.